everybody. Welcome to... Oh, just 1 minute. I have to check the volume. Okay. Restart. Hello, everybody. This is Dana. Welcome to Healthy Kitchens, Healthy Lives, our monthly edition of cooking wholesome, engaging, flavorful, fantastic food. And we're doing it a little bit differently this time. I have a very special guest with me who's actually a new staff member, so we'll be seeing a lot more of her in many different ways. I'm so excited to have Patty joining me today.
I'm excited to be here.
And Patty is the liaison to patient experience in the warmest sense of the word. And she is the one that if you're new to Lifescape or newer, you'll have met her right away. If you are a long-time Lifescape patient, then feel free to stop by and say hi to her when you're in the building. And she'll be posting and engaging and doing all kinds of wonderful stuff for you. But today she just gets to step out of that role of busyness and step into the role of sous chef and
and
partner.
And cooking helper, right.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Excited.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Exactly. And so we're making today a dish that really speaks to summer. And although we just recently went through the summer solstice, this is truly like the epitome of summer. And we're making a dish that's based on one of the really abundant summer vegetables. It's a zucchini. And Patty and I wanted to just chat a little bit about the dish, and then we're going to dive into the cooking portion.
Right.
So, Patty, this is a dish. It's a zucchini noodle with a homemade dairy-free pesto and a alternative protein source. Have you ever experienced anything like this before?
Yes. Well, zucchini's probably my favorite vegetable, so this is fun for me to be here and learn a new way to prepare. The noodle, we were talking the other day when people say, you know, gee, it's a zucchini noodle. You know, it's not a substitute. It stands on its own. You know, so oftentimes we don't try other things because we think of it in those terms. And it's, you know, gosh, I just encourage people to try new things and explore not think of things like zucchini, noodles, or spaghetti squash, or items like that as a substitute for pasta. They are fabulous all on their own and a really good way to have fun.
Yeah, I love that. Mm-hmm. So this is, you guys, this is a really key point. I just want to emphasize it again because Patty is so spot on in that a lot of times when we are thinking about carbohydrates like pasta made from flour, we're thinking, oh, that's bad for us,
we don't
want it, it's going to shoot our blood sugar up and build belly fat and all that sort of thing. Well, that's true, but then when we're thinking about changing it up and, you know, like, to your point, it's sort of like, well, if I can't have this, I'll have that. And instead, it's this idea of, I'm just going to put that thing aside right now, but I'm going to bring in this other abundance of diversity instead of thinking of it as a substitute, which kind of makes us feel flat.
Right.
Because it's not the same thing.
It's not a sacrifice. It's actually, you know, so incredibly enjoyable. They're not going to lose the recipe for spaghetti and meatballs, I promise. So if we try something new, you know, and expand, you know, the variety of foods that we have, that's super exciting, you know, and fun.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. So that's a perfect note to get going on, which is, cooking is all about having fun in the kitchen, and it's, you know, I like to cook. It's therapeutic for me. It makes me feel good on many levels, but I have to say, you know, like, the thought that I knew that Patty was going to be helping me today really amped up the excitement.
Oh, good.
She doesn't know that, but
well, she hasn't seen me do anything yet, so I hope I can help.
But it really is true, you know, bringing in somebody else to enjoy and participate in the process is great. And I always tell my patients, if you have kids, I don't care what age they
are. Kids love to
cook. As long as they're going to be safe in the kitchen, that gets them engaged. And the sooner children are engaged, the more likely they are to keep those habits when they're on their own.
Right. And cooking's so creative.
Yeah.
And it's just so fun, you know, to do.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So as Patty sous chef some stuff for us. I'm going to go a little bit onto the clinical side, or not clinical, but just the nutrition side, and talk a little bit about some of those key elements as to why we're choosing these certain foods. So as always, you guys, I shop for everything fresh. I purchase organic, and we're running that theme continually. Yeah, because the quality of the food you buy dictates the flavor.
Absolutely.
So, especially in a dish like this where there's so few ingredients, you really want to focus on the quality piece. And I'll give some alternatives as we move through. Like Patty said, like you said in the beginning, zucchini noodles or spaghetti squash or any kind of zoodle, you know, essentially, right? You know, a sweet potato, a butternut squash, those can all be sort of zoodled. And so you can play around with any of those ideas,
right?
You know, during this time.
Make it fun.
Yeah. So one recipe is like five or six, really. You know, if you want to play with it. But we're doing the zucchini today in honor of summer. And the first thing I want to do is we're going to get in our kitchen mode.
Oh.
And so I'm going to ask Patty that we have a little like a little treat for you guys. We're in the process of personalizing. So we have our Lifescape aprons we're going to put on for you guys.
So you know who we are and where we are.
Right? And there's no doubt that you're in the Lifescape kitchen, right? So look for even more fancy aprons in the future. And you know what? I encourage you to get an apron when you're cooking because, one, it kind of sets you in that mode, right? You're in that mindset of getting your gear on, essentially. You guys know I'm very active. Patty's active. We both really believe in fitness and moving. And I mean, when you wake up in the morning and you're thinking like, I'm not sure if I want to work out or not. If you step into your workout,
go
process,
through the
right? Doesn't that kind of get you? And then you turn on some music.
Right.
And next thing, guess what?
Right. You're moving. And no one ever feels bad returning from a nice long walk. You might drag on your way out, but on your way back, you just feel energized and excited. So yeah, it just takes a step.
Exactly.
And there you go.
So if you learn nothing else from this cooking demo today, it's, you know, to set yourself up for success for whatever you do. And so we're in our success aprons, and we're gonna get going. So I'm so excited that Patty's gonna be able to help with this. So what she's going to do is we have these beautiful organic zucchinis, and you can see that even these very little in size, they can be this small, even smaller, and this is close to 8 inches maybe, but they can go up to 3 feet long. So
I've seen some,
in the
my dad has
garden.
Grown, right, I mean, you know, he's a Sicilian man, so he grows lots of zucchini and eggplants, and they can be amazing.
It's fantastic. So we're using the smaller ones because that's what I had available to me at the store. And so what we're going to do is spiralize them. You can buy them already spiralized if you want. It's a company called CC Veggieco, C-E-C-E apostrophe S, CC's Veggieco. But you can do it on your own. And if you have your own equipment, then guess what? You can zoodle. So
I'm excited. I've never zoodled.
Who knew? Who knew we would zoodle at Lifescape? So this is like it's kind of an older model. There's new ones, but I'm just tamping it down onto the table, and then I'm pulling down this little handle. So Patty's gonna hold on to this, and I'm just gonna show her how I do one, and then she's gonna take over and be the master.
Okay.
So I've just, you know, washed these off, and this is an important tip, is don't take the skin off. A lot of people feel this need to, like, take off skin off the carrots and the cucumbers and the zucchini. And you know what? There's so many nutrients in the skin that you don't want to take it out, and especially in the zucchini, the skin is where all the antioxidants are.
The dark green.
Exactly. The pigments.
Right.
And so, just a tip on that, in case you were thinking, if you buy organic and you wash it, it's
fine, right?
So, I'm so excited, I forgot the blade. So there's a series of blades, and I brought my little container. And we're gonna use this one today. It's got smaller holes on it, and it's amazing how it works. You guys just watch. So I'm gonna stick it in here. And this is fun for all ages. You don't even have to cut the top off. So you just stick the bottom onto the sharp spot, keeping your fingers out of there. And then you press into the top. And then all you have going on here is you just simply rotate, and out comes curly.
That's so fun.
Isn't this great? And this is the
I think I can do this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's the angel hair setting. And you can see how thin. That means these are going to cook really fast. Mm-hmm. And it's fun to do. It doesn't take a lot of effort. It's massively therapeutic.
Tell me what this piece of equipment is called again.
It's called a spiralizer.
Spiralizer.
Yeah, okay. And you can get these on Amazon, mm-hmm. Bed Bath & Beyond, Target. And then the middle is left. Mm-hmm. This is fine. You can eat the middle. Yeah. So we'll just keep that aside, and we'll chop it up into little pieces mm-hmm. when we're done. So you can see that we have this beautiful hair pasta, essentially. So we'll set that over here, mm-hmm. and then I'm going to have Patty go ahead and give it a go. Mm-hmm. So she's going to just stick the
This is my first one. So.
First ever. My first ever zoodle.
Uh-huh. And you were all here to witness it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Lock that in.
Yep. So you want to put your left hand on this handle.
Okay.
And then press. And
oh, wait. I don't think I did this good. Okay. They're all laughing at me.
There you go.
Okay.
No, she's... we're with you.
Okay. Got it.
Yeah. And just move it, guide it through. Exactly.
Okay.
And sometimes if the neck of the zucchini is wobbly, mm-hmm. you can cut that off to make it
straighter so that it goes through easier.
Exactly.
Uh-huh.
But if it's...
I'm okay with the wobbly zucchini.
So as she's going through uh-huh. and doing that, it's coming out the other side in these beautiful long strands, mm-hmm. just kind of like my
my
hair. Mm-hmm. Nice long curly
strands. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So you can just start gathering, and you can make as much of this or as little. You can mm-hmm. make extra, and it's great the mm-hmm. next day. So that's fine. We're going to zoodle at least three of these. Mm-hmm. I always have extra on hand because I'm not sure how much I want to use. Mm-hmm. So as she's going through and doing that, I want to make a comment that the type of antioxidants that are in the zucchini are called carotenoids, and carotenoids in this particular sense are lutein and beta carotene, and that's again what we're talking about to give that bright green pigmentation. So that's the component of that antioxidant family that we're really looking for. And you may have heard of lutein also in terms of eye health and prostate health. So we cover a lot of bases when we bring whole food into our diet. The other thing I want to talk about with zucchini is that it's rich in two kinds of fiber, soluble and insoluble. So it kind of dances between the two. And I want to just back up and mention that zucchini is actually technically a fruit. We consider it a vegetable, but it's really a fruit alongside cucumber and spaghetti squash, which is kind of why it's so palatable to so many people, because it tends to be higher water content and a little sweeter. And that's why it's like technically more in the vegetable side, it's more on the fruit in a botanical classification. And that soluble fiber is the food that feeds a bacteria in our gut. And that's really important because the bacteria send signals to every organ system in our body and keep us healthy. If those signaling are down and it's not working, then we start feeling it and we notice it. So soluble fiber feeds those good healthy bacteria. And then the insoluble fiber helps add bulk to the stool and carries all that toxic waste that we have left over from metabolism out. So it's hitting you on both sides is super beneficial. And it's really rich in potassium. And a lot of my patients are thinking about potassium in terms of blood pressure. So when we have adequate potassium in our diet, along with other nutrients, blood pressure is usually in that nice, safe, healthy range. And that's important as well. So lots of benefits coming out of this in many different ways. And Patty's doing a fantastic job. This looks great. Look at this huge pile of noodles.
I know.
And you know what, you guys, these, as with all vegetables, these will cook down and sort of dissipate. So it's better to have more and go from there. You can eat these raw, just as they are.
It'd be so nice in a salad or to add that extra texture in a salad.
Yeah, and right now we're thinking, you know, coming into 4th of July weekend, maybe this is a dish that you'd want to share with people if you're going to somebody's house for a barbecue.
I'm going to have to get a spiralizer, like,
immediately.
Tomorrow.
Yeah. Amazon Prime.
That's right.
So she did a really nice job with that. There's other blades, and you can make all kinds of shapes with them. Really enjoyable. So we're going to just move over here. And it takes a village to do a cooking class, so I appreciate everyone's help today. And Patty, this looks fantastic. So the next step we're going to do is, it says in the recipe to wrap the zucchini in paper towels. This is a cool point, and you were the one who brought this up.
Well, because I've cooked vegetables like this, you know, like potatoes, trying to make potato pancakes, things like that, and there's so much liquid, and they're so full of wonderful liquid, but it can dilute, you know, anything that maybe you'll put on it, and the recipe becomes really watery. I'm not a cook, and I'm certainly not you. But I read the recipe prior, and I thought, oh my gosh, that's why everything's so soggy for me. So that one tip is going to change things.
Yeah, it is. You know, and that's really it. The key to good cooking, one, is the ingredients, but two, it's knowing how to prepare them in advance and prep them for the recipe. And those are the things that you just kind of know inherently when you cook a lot.
Right.
But you also know when you're not doing it right, that something isn't working.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is, I just have a few paper towels, and I'm just going to put two on the bottom of this strainer. And then we're just going to use this nice foldy cutting board. And we're just going to make a shoot right into this strainer.
Right, that's so simple. You know, I think people sometimes feel I know sometimes I feel overwhelmed. I'll look at a recipe and I'll say, well, that looks wonderful. I wish someone would make it for me.
Right, exactly.
But because it feels like it can be too difficult, but you learn these little tips and, you know, it's just amazing.
It is. Mm-hmm. It makes a difference.
Yeah.
So I just put a little bit of salt on there.
What kind of salt did you use?
This is a pink Himalayan sea
love
salt.
That.
And then I'm just going to cover the zucchini up and press on it a little bit. And this will give it a chance to, the salt pulls water out of the zucchini, and it'll allow it to, if it does drip at all, it'll drip into our bowl on the bottom. So we're just going to let that rest for a little bit while we move into the next phase of the event. So the next piece that we want to do is we want to start sauteing the onions and the tempeh. Okay, Patty.
I've never
used experience with it.
None.
Perfect.
Right.
I mean, really.
Really? Is that perfect?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is because I love introducing new foods to people.
Right.
And for some people, soy is a thing that they avoid, and there is a legitimate reason. And for others, it can be really beneficial. So, you know, take note. If you're one that's okay with soy for various reasons, this is probably one of the best sources, because it's fermented. So this is tempeh, and tempeh is a cultured fermented soybean, and it has a much chewier texture than like traditional tofu, which tends to be kind of soft and mushy and not enjoyable for folks. The reason I like this too, this particular one is from my favorite store, Sprouts. Everybody who watches each other knows. And it's the one I go to is on Pinnacle Peak in Scottsdale. I understand they're not all that fantastic, but this one is really great. Mm-hmm. So this is just an organic tempeh, and just take note that this is just soybean. There are some that have mixed grains in them, and you want to notice that because some of those grains may be off of a certain diet or protocol. Mm-hmm. So just get the plain version, and this is organic and has a lot of interesting health benefits. So what we're going to do is experiment with that. As I mentioned, if you don't want to use soy products in your diet, you can substitute any protein in here. One of my personal favorites with this is shrimp.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that would be great.
Yeah. And I just buy the little small wild-caught shrimp that are already peeled and deveined and just perfect.
Right.
And you can defrost them that morning in the refrigerator and then cook them up in the time. Mm-hmm. So that's one alternative. And of course, there's plenty of other proteins.
Sure.
So depending on how you want this dish to go, plant-based or have a little bit of a pump to it.
You could probably just add some other little interesting vegetables too. Just chop something up in there that you... mushrooms or something. I love mushroom and zucchini combination. That add a good flavor, a good portobello.
I was just
thinking, that would be delicious.
You know, portobello, because that's
nice. Look,
I'm
a cook
meeting.
Now.
Next guest lined up for the show. So I'm on an induction stovetop. It heats up really fast. So I just got it on a low moderate heat. We're just using an extra virgin olive oil. You can use ghee, that's in the recipe, or coconut oil. It's up to you. As long as you have the heat on low to medium, olive oil is happy. So we're just going to put that in the skillet. And like I said, this warms up very quickly. So you can, you're going to hear it beat because induction means magnet. And if it's not in contact with the pan, it turns off. It's really cool. Very few people have inductions in their homes, but it is a nice thing. So... I took some of the work out of Patty's hands, and I
thank you.
I pre-fried an onion.
I'm not a fan of cutting up onions.
Yeah, it can be a teary experience. So onions are essential to this dish because they bring in that umami, that sort of extra depth of flavor. And also, onions are super nice because they're rich in sulfur. And sulfur, you guys, is really good for detoxification. It helps support some of the phases of detoxification in the liver.
Right.
So, and also is a prebiotic. So prebiotic foods feed gut bacteria. So I'm going to pass this over to Patty.
And I'm going to start them in here.
Carefully put them in the pan because it's going to be hot. You can hear the sizzle. And as you guys noticed, I warmed up the pan first. And then I put in the oil. And I just can't emphasize this enough to everybody, how important that is, because if you heat up the pan too hot and you have the oil already in there, not only is your pan too hot, but your oil is too hot. And one of the biggest culprits of inflaming our bodies is eating burned oil.
Oh.
Right?
I'm learning. Wow, Dana.
Yeah. So, it's not just like, oh, that would be nice to not have the oil so hot.
Right.
It's really about, you know, we spend all this time and energy buying these beautiful organic ingredients and preparing them with love and excitement.
Right.
But if we burn the oil because we've got it in the pan and it's just whoosh, up to 500 degrees, not very good. So one of the top three things that I talk to my patients about is the quality of the oil they use. And also the temperature that they heat it to. And I've been giving out a nice chart to my patients that show which oils can go to which temperature so they don't smoke. So that's actually a really important thing. So we're just going to let these simmer for just a few minutes. And you can play around with the heat. The nice thing about induction is once it's on, it's on, and it doesn't fade in and out like electric. So if you guys have electric, you have to watch your heat. But I think this is going to be good. So we'll let it
move them around? Or?
Yeah, maybe just let them sit for a minute or two. That's a really good point, is sometimes when we're cooking, we tend to get into the food too much.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to just let it do its thing for a little bit and then come back and visit it.
Mm-hmm.
And the onions, you know when they're done because they start getting translucent.
Mm-hmm.
And it's up to you too. I mean, if you want them a little crunchier,
mm-hmm.
but my experience is that the softer they get, the sweeter they are.
Right.
Right. And that's always super appealing.
Mm-hmm.
So that's another thing with texture, is you don't want to have too many opposing textures in a food. If you want something crunchy and on purpose, you want to add like some seeds or nuts.
Mm-hmm.
That's different than having a crunchy onion and a soft zucchini.
Right. Right.
There's something about that in the mouth that
mm-hmm.
doesn't say, wow, this is great.
Mm-hmm. It does just blend.
Yeah.
So when it's burning oil, but what about caramelizing, like onions, things like that? Is that okay? Or?
So caramelizing, and forgive me, you guys, I'm not a trained chef, but my understanding is that's when you use sugar. So caramelizing is not necessarily high heat, but it's putting in like a sugar, like a sugary balsamic,
oh.
a root, like a reduced balsamic,
okay.
and that actually starts caramelizing them as they cook.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't believe you have to have a super high heat to do that.
Okay.
Again, you know, could be wrong on that because I'm not classically
right.
trained, but that's kind of my understanding of it. And I do a caramelized onion when I put a mushroom onion combination
mm-hmm.
together, and I add a reduced balsamic maple.
Oh, lovely.
Mm-hmm. That's really, really nice. So
can we make that next?
Yeah. That's next
that
on
sounds
the docket.
Good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, Patty, maybe
okay.
give
yeah.
it a go and see how that looks.
Okay.
And remember, we're going to be adding some tempeh to this shortly. And so, you know, the onions will keep cooking
mm-hmm.
alongside. But really, it is important to get the onions started ahead of time because I find if you don't get them sauteed to a certain point and then you start adding food,
mm-hmm.
they never really fully get to that translucent stage. I can't explain why, but it is my experience that that happens.
Mm-hmm.
So as she's doing that, I want to talk a little bit about the pesto sauce. And this I went ahead and made in advance because it's a food processor requirement. And so you want to take pine nuts, and these are just little tiny shelled nuts, and they come in bulk at Sprouts.
Mm-hmm.
And this is an option too, if you're not a fan of pine nuts, you can't find them, or something's going on. You can actually use any kind of nut in here. So I've used cashews to make pesto, walnuts, even almonds. So again, this is where variation can come in. This is the classic item for pesto, is the pine nut. And then you're gonna add olive oil to the food processor. So the first thing I do is put the pine nuts in. And then you add the oil, you actually drizzle in as the one
mm-hmm.
to turn the food processor on. If you don't do it that way initially, it's okay, but it really does work out better if you start rotating the blade and then drizzle it in the soup. And then you want to add a bunch of fresh basil. So I used this container. If you want to grow basil at home, I love that idea,
mm-hmm.
you know, in a container.
And you can put it in your freezer, as I understand. You know?
Yeah, if you cut it up and you can make basil ice cubes,
mm-hmm.
and you can keep it that way.
Mm-hmm.
And so I ended up using two full packages of this to
mm-hmm.
make the pesto today because it was 1.5 cups in the recipe. So,
but that's so convenient too. Wow.
Yeah, it's
I didn't like that.
Super easy.
Mm-hmm.
You just pluck off the stems and then
we're all busy. That you know to be able to get good things and. You know, healthy, organic foods and have them be convenient.
Easy to do,
mm-hmm.
yeah. And basil is part of the mint family, and it's different varieties. This is just a sweet basil, but you can also buy the Thai basil or Greek basil.
Mm-hmm.
They all have a little different tone to them, so depending on the kind of dish you're making, you can experiment with varieties.
Mm-hmm.
There's purple basil. There's actually
mm-hmm.
many varieties. And we don't see those always in the store, but farmers markets will carry
mm-hmm.
them. And if you want to go ahead and experiment by growing your own,
mm-hmm.
a storage tip for basil is if you have it on a long stem, you want to actually store the stems in a glass of water. and it keeps it basil mm-hmm. fresh longer.
In the fruit.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
if you're going to use it for plating. And if you have a basil plant and you want to take basil off of it to cook with, the instinct is to snip off leaves at the top.
Mm-hmm.
You actually want to snip at the bottom, the whole stem, and then the plant will grow up from the stem.
Mm-hmm.
So just a couple of stir-dips. So we could zoom in on the onions and see that they are really nice and translucent, and they smell fantastic. They're even browning a little
mm-hmm.
bit. So that's the golden spot right there. So now we're going to go ahead and add the tempeh that came out of the package. And I just rough chopped this into bite-sized pieces.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just...
So is there a soy kind of flavor to the tempeh because it's fermented? Yes?
Yeah, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's no doubt about
like
that.
Like a soy saucy...
Yeah, it's
mm-hmm.
not... I think it is a little different though because of the fermentation.
Mm-hmm.
I think it has a little bit different flavor.
And fermented foods are good, so good for us.
Yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
For gut health and just overall.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know.
No, you do.
Oh,
you're
okay.
Perfect. That's exactly right. The fermented foods
mm-hmm.
Lend to bringing in good natural
mm-hmm.
probiotics
mm-hmm.
that the gut really craves and loves.
Mm-hmm.
So, as she's going through and doing that, we're going to just, the tempeh doesn't need to really cook a super long time,
mm-hmm.
so we're just going to let it brown and warm up and get sort of the blending of flavors with the onions. And here, you would think about adding garlic, but that's where the pesto comes in. So I'll go back to finishing up that ritual pesto. So you've got your pine nuts in there and your basil, and then you want to put in two or three cloves of garlic. And all you need to do is just roll them in a garlic roller, a little silicone tube, and the skin just pops right off. And you don't have to cut the garlic at all. Just take the whole clove and put it into your food processor, and it'll whiz it right up.
Mm-hmm.
So there's actually very little cutting involved in this whole recipe, which is really nice.
Yeah.
And then I have a fresh lemon that I squeeze in a portion of it.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to just, with pesto, you just want to taste it as you go. So add some salt, add the lemon, drizzle in the olive oil, and then keep blending and tasting. I'm going to give you guys a secret. This is not in the recipe.
Okay.
So anybody who's watching, this is a bonus for you. So normally pesto has Parmesan in it, or Romano.
Mm-hmm.
This is a dairy-free pesto. When I tasted it this morning, I thought it needs a little something.
Mm-hmm.
And I had this on hand. I always carry nutritional yeast.
Oh.
Yeah, and so the package is a little bit wrinkled. Here, you can see better on this side. And this is in bulk at Sprouts. And you just keep it in the pantry. Nutritional yeast does not contribute to candida overgrowth. I have a lot of people think that.
Mm-hmm.
This is a different strain of yeast. And it's really rich in B vitamins, so a lot of vegans will use this
mm-hmm.
as a substitute.
Mm-hmm.
It has a salty, cheesy taste to it. And so I sprinkled some of this into the
mm-hmm.
pesto mix, and it popped. So this is, again, the stuff where you're like, oh, that recipe
mm-hmm.
wasn't, what happened? It wasn't the same.
Mm-hmm.
Well, because I'm a cook and I do little things like this.
Mm-hmm.
So, we'll see if we can post that online, that this was a little secret tip.
This smells wonderful.
It does.
Yeah.
It's starting to really
mm-hmm.
smell good, so you can tell all the seasonings
mm-hmm.
and spices are starting to go in there. And normally I'd be throwing in garlic and
mm-hmm.
salt and pepper, but we
you
have all of that
to
in the
pesto.
Pesto.
Right.
Exactly.
Something you could pre-make and then very easily, you know, with guests and things, you don't have to be tied up in the kitchen. You can, you know, I'm a fan of pre-making. So I can also have fun with my guests, you know, and serve
yeah.
them really good food. So,
that's exactly.
You know,
this is
so great.
Patty, I love that because cooking has to be fun and it
mm-hmm.
can't be something like
a
chore. A
chore, no.
Yeah. So now
yeah.
we're getting to the point where we're ready.
This is looking a little brown in there.
It's,
so.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
so we're ready to add in the zucchini.
Oh.
So
yay.
We'll
the star of the show, the zucchini.
And then...
Mm-hmm.
We've got it in here, it's ready to go,
mm-hmm.
and look at that, it's just absolutely
I think I did a really
so
good
fun.
Job.
Oh, yeah. Patty is the new zoodle queen. cheese in here.
So how do you know if you want to add a little extra oil? If does it,
yeah, so that's if it's starting to look dry and brown.
On the bottom, it feels a little like
right.
No, I'm right with you, Patty.
Okay.
So this is where your cook's instinct is coming
right.
in. Right. And you just want to drizzle a little bit of extra.
Right.
Because we are going to add some more, we're adding the pesto.
Right, the more,
it,
right.
But we don't want to burn our food before we get to that.
Right.
So.
This, oh my goodness, this is.
We've got that.
I think even our camera person is getting, hoping she gets a taste.
Yeah, absolutely.
Maybe.
I want to give a shout out to our lovely Caitlin. She's filming today. And you guys, some of you may know her because she's mm-hmm. the first person that you come in contact with
uh-huh.
when you call or come in the office. And we're thank you. We're honored to have you helping.
Thank you,
Caitlin.
Of course.
And as you can see, the zucchini is turning colors quickly, right? It's starting to get bright and vibrant.
Mm-hmm.
And so that means, you know, like I said, it's that angel hair. Just like with angel hair pasta,
mm-hmm.
it's thin, it's going to cook quickly.
Right.
So we're not trying to overcook it. Like you said, Patty, you don't want it to get mushy.
Right, right. Lovely.
Because we want a little bit of texture there
mm-hmm.
for that bite. Because we do all eat for texture. So I'm thinking just a few more minutes
mm-hmm.
and we can go ahead and mix in the pesto. One thing I want to do is, just while she finishes that, is let you know that zucchini is so versatile. And that's
mm-hmm.
great, because like if you're getting that big, you know, 3-inch long zucchini, you need
mm-hmm.
a bunch of ways to use it.
Mm-hmm.
So you can stuff it, and there's no end to what the stuffing can be. It can be a meat-based stuffing or vegetable-based.
Mm-hmm.
And you can also just slice it into circles and saute it with some onions
mm-hmm.
and tomatoes, keep it really simple. You can shred it and then make it into, like you said, tiny
mm-hmm.
pancakes,
right?
Which are one of my all-time favorites. You can
delicious.
Do it, add
right.
it to a stir fry with some bok choy
mm-hmm.
and some rainbow carrots. Like we said earlier, you can eat it raw
mm-hmm.
As part of a salad.
Right.
I would think of like a salad like this, and I would probably even zoodle some broccoli
mm-hmm.
and mix it in with the zucchini and maybe some
right.
some like, you know, medjool dates and some
oh, that sounds delicious.
Sliced
yeah.
almonds and
right, wow.
So there's no
mm-hmm.
end to the fun here.
Right. It's fun to be creative like that.
Yeah.
And
exactly. So then the next
mm-hmm.
thing we're gonna do is
this
add
looks
in
so fabulous.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think you know what, I'm just going to turn off the heat.
Right.
Because like we said, we just wanted to gently cook it. So here's the beautiful pesto. And this is all the ingredients I mentioned. The pine nuts, the lemon, the olive oil, garlic,
mm-hmm.
and the secret ingredient, the
yeast.
The yeast? Yeah, to give it that cheesy undertone.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to say it was kind of brilliant.
Well,
adding it in.
I'm not surprised.
Yeah. So we're just gonna, I made a lot because obviously I always make more than the recipe calls for because I have a LifeScape family here of staff people that are always wondering when it's time to sample. So Patty, go ahead and give that a mix in and
uh-huh.
see. And you can use pesto in so many different ways. You can even make eggs pesto, you know, so
mm-hmm.
you can have some for
mm-hmm.
the next day. And
oh, that
you could
smells amazing.
Do like some eggs and chicken sausage
mm-hmm.
and pesto and like a side of sweet potato.
Oh.
Yeah. See, there's so much to do. And so if you have a bigger batch like we have here
mm-hmm.
and you want to use it all on that, that's fine too. So you can just mix it in right into the skillet once it's off. And I think I'm going to add a little more right over here. And the smells coming from this are fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
They remind you of summer, fresh, vibrant.
Mm.
And you know, when you eat like this, you feel so good at the end of the day.
And satisfied. I think
yeah.
people, you know, you absolutely feel satisfied. And
that's really the key.
Mm-hmm.
And good people always tell me, Dana, I just feel like I overeat. I think it's because the food doesn't have the satisfying
right.
flavor.
Right.
Doesn't need to be complex. It
right.
just needs to have undertones of
right.
fresh. So this looks really
amazing.
So thank you, Patty, for
It was so fun, Dana. That was so fun, and I learned things.
You can see that it's cooking is always an experience worth having or sharing. Mm-hmm. And we're gonna now, if you would like, Patty, she's gonna get a chance to show off her muscle.
Sure.
We're just gonna have you put that into a big serving bowl, and then I'm gonna serve it with these tongs that are no longer tongs.
She's gonna serve it with those two spoons.
My muscles and Patty's muscles are too big. And so I'm just gonna let people scoop that out and give it a go. And if you want, you could always sprinkle a little pine nuts.
Something,
over the
yeah.
Top. You know, just to give
so
it
great.
Like a little.
Looks really lovely. And delicious.
So we're just gonna,
it smells hearty, like a, you know, like something that's really going to satisfy you. And I think it's not amounts of foods, it truly is. It's the flavor, it's the smells, it's the company.
Yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
Yeah. So it's all of those things that make a meal satisfying.
So we've garnished it. You can even keep some fresh basil leaves out and chop those up and add a little garnish on top. You could put a few cherry tomatoes on there to add some little pop of color.
Right.
You know, it's just fun to play.
We actually had a question from a viewer of how much yeast you added.
Oh, thank you. That's great. Let me think about that. It was a couple big sprinkles. So, 2 tablespoons, I think would be fair. You could give that a go. Start off maybe with 1 and then taste it and see what you like. But I just thought it really needed that. And trust me, I think it made a big difference.
Mm-hmm. I think, yeah, the smells.
Thank you for that. Thank you for asking. So we're going to wrap up the session today and let all of the Lifescape family know that there's something new to try in the house. And Caitlin's the first one that gets an opportunity.
So excited. It smells great.
It smells great.
So keep in mind that healthy food brings about goodness in so many ways. It brings us together.
It
nourishes us from the inside out, and then we can glow from the inside out. So if you're interested in learning more about how to make this food or other food, or you want to dig into your nutrition a little bit more personalized, I'm available for consultation with Lifescape members and non-Lifescape members. So if you have family, friends, or community that would like some help, or even just simply getting a menu together, I have an amazing way to do that, and I'm happy to personalize. So reach out to Caitlin or someone at the front desk and they can schedule you. If you need help with other Lifescape things, Patty's here for you.
Sure. And I can also connect you with Dana if you're lucky enough to get in and have that consultation. Amazing. Truly, food meat is so much more than just flavors and filling us. It just can be life-changing. And Dana makes it so easy.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
So, my pleasure having you.
Aww.